What's up? Welcome back to my channel. So first off, I wanted to say, what did you guys think of that intro? I created that on Keynote and I just wanted to try it out. I've never had like an intro before. I've always had an outro, but I've never had an intro. And with my new computer, I have Keynote now. And so I was messing around with Keynote and so I created that. But that is beside the point. This video is going to be the Instagram versus real life makeup. And I thought that would be a fun video to film. So if you guys do enjoy this, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and click the subscribe button so you are notified when the next video is up. And click that little bell button because I guess YouTube now is not letting people know when they upload, pretty much. So if you click that bell button, then it will notify you every time I upload a video. And yeah, without further ado, let's get on to this Instagram versus real life makeup video. So I'm gonna do my right side, the Instagram makeup, and on the left side, the real life makeup. Now, real life, outside of YouTube, I do not wear makeup. Sometimes on occasion, if I have to, for work, if I have to wear makeup, then I will, but it's literally like nothing. It's pretty much just foundation and that's it. So with that being said, I might just do just a little bit of foundation, but other than that, I do not wear makeup outside of YouTube. So there's that, but let's just get on to the Instagram side because that's kind of the more fun and exciting side to do. So the first thing I'm going to do with both my Instagram and the real life side, I'm going to be doing a primer and I'm going to be using the NYX Angel Veil Primer. And I'm just going to place a little bit of that onto my finger. And then I'm just going to dab that on my face. Just blend that in. So today I'm wearing a hat because my hair is just, it needs a haircut. And I couldn't find a beanie at the moment when I was looking. So I threw on a hat. So that is why I'm wearing a hat today. But, so I just put this angel veil on. And in like a previous video, I don't remember if it's a previous video or a couple videos before, I said I didn't like it. And the thing I don't necessarily like about it, I don't know. It seems too, like, I don't know the word I'm looking for, but it feels weird on my face to me. That's just my opinion. It feels weird on my face to me. Maybe I need to get another one and see, but yeah. I will say the thing about this is it does feel soft on the skin, so I do feel like it may, in a way, smooth out pores and whatnot, so there's that. But for the Instagram side, I'm going to be going in with my Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 foundation, and yeah, so I'm going to put that actually on the back of my hand. I'm just going to do one pump of that. I'm going to go in with a damp beauty blender. This is the Real Beauty Blender. So I'm just going to take that and just pounce that on the skin. Just put that all on my brow. I did. Totally did. I did. So. going to take a spoolie brush and just brush that out, what I put in my brow. I'm gonna take a little bit more on my beauty blender. Okay, so as you can see, there is half of my face with some foundation, and what's left of the foundation I'm bringing onto the neck. Foundation is on, now I'm gonna go in with concealer. Concealer I use is the LA Girl Pro Concealer. This is in Creamy Beige. As you see, that's really, really bright. Go down the nose and forehead. Half the cupid's bow, and then chin. I'm gonna take my beauty blender and just blend that out. Now that my face is highlighted, the Instagram side, I'm going to set that with the Smashbox in light. I'm gonna go in with the Real Techniques setting brush and just take that, dust off the excess, and just pat. I am also going to take this powder and just set the whole face. Now I'm just going to go in with another Real Techniques. This is the powder brush, and I'm just going to get a decent amount of this powder and just full face on the Instagram side. So now that we have that down, so now that the powder and concealer is on, I'm gonna go in with bronzer, and I'm gonna be using the NYX Highlight and Contour palette. And I'm just gonna be using the lightest shade and then the shade Sculpt, which is the second to the end, and just contour. Go with some more Sculpt. Jawline that I never knew I had. Hello. This might be an everyday thing. I may just add this to just everyday. You know. Just saying. Because now, look at that side. And then look at that side. Difference. Amazing, amazing. So then, next, now that we have the face all done on this side, I'm gonna go in with my eyes. And I want to go in with my BH Party Girl palette and play with some fun colors. I'm going to be using to prime my eyes my NYX HD Concealer. Just use a little bit of that, just one full swipe, maybe two, on the eyes. And then I'm going to go in with another setting brush from Real Techniques and just blending that out. So now that I have that primed, I'm gonna go in actually with a little bit more and just prime underneath the eye. And I'm actually gonna go in with a blending brush now and just blend that out. Further blend out that on top. So then, now that your whole eye is primed, I'm just going to go in with, I don't know what powder I'm going to go in to set this. I'm going to go in with a banana shade in the highlight and contour palette. I'm going to take a little bit of that and just dust that on the eye. So now I'm going to just pretty much turn this into a tutorial. So I'm gonna go in with, gonna go back in with the highlight and contour palette. I'm gonna use the lightest shade in the palette and just take a little bit of that and use that as a transition. So I'm going to go in with the BH Party Girl palette, and I am going to, I'm going to go in with this shade right here. I'm going to go in to take that and place that on the inner corner of my eye. Next, I'm gonna go, I don't know if I wanna do some crazy colors today or what. Kinda wanna go in with a purple. I think I wanna take this purple shade and dust that on the lid. So I'm gonna take a generous amount of this. As you can see, there's a decent amount of that. I'm just going to dust that on my lid. And gradually pulling it in. Take some more of that. Pack it on. So, and once I'm done with that, I kind of think I want to deepen the lower lash line. So I'm going to be going in with a black liner. If I can find my black liner. I'm going to be taking an oldie but goodie. This is Black Bean by NYX. This is like an OG type of liner, so I'm going to be taking that and I'm going to be placing that on my waterline. I'm going to be dragging this down just so I can smudge it. wow, I haven't used this in like a hot second and I kind of missed it. So next I'm going to go in with a pencil brush and I'm just going to be taking, I don't know if I want to go back in with that purple shade or if I want to do another shade. What should I do? What should I do? What should I do? I kind of want to go in with this shimmery black. Kind of low-key want to go in with the blue. Or should I just stick to the purple and just do like a purple? Maybe I will. Maybe that's what I'll do. I'll stick to the purple a little bit and then I'll do other colors, you know, just to have fun with it. So I'm actually going to go in with, I'm going to go in with the Morphe E18 brush and I'm going to go back in with that purple shade, get a decent amount, tap off the excess, and I'm going to smudge that on my lower lash line. Take a little bit more. Super deep and smoky. So I'm gonna go in with another shade. I'm gonna go in, I think, with this light pink right here and just place that on top of the purple. Get a gentle amount, tap off the excess. So I wanted to just pull that down. Now I'm gonna go in with a blending brush and just blend that out. So then once you got that down, I'm gonna go back in with my other blending brush. This is the E22 from Morphe. And I'm just going to go back in with the light contour shade and just add a little more transition. Super light. Real light hand, you wanna hold it further back. You wanna hold the handle of the brush further back and that will give you a lighter hand. Okay, so now that you have that blended out, I'm going to go in with, I want to use a matte shade for this one, for the brow bone. So I'm going to go in with Shimma Shimma from Makeup Geek. This is the only Makeup Geek that I have. I feel so bad. It's so, like, lonely. But I'm gonna go to the brow bone with that. I'm gonna go back in with that blending brush. I'm just going to blend. So we got that down. Then next, I'm gonna go in with and do brows. I'm gonna go in with the NYX Tame&Frame brow product. Now, what's really nice about my eyebrows are that they are naturally like shaped with an arch, so it's not that hard for me to really carve out a brow. So, really, really happy about that. So, mom and dad, thanks for that. I always get asked, that's like one of my number one questions I get asked as a makeup artist is, do you get your brows waxed or threaded or pluck or anything of that sort? And no, they're literally, these are my brows. That is them. I do nothing to them. The only thing I do is I will fill them in with a pencil or a pomade. And this is the, like I said, the NYX Tame&Frame tinted brow pomade. This is in black, so it makes it even more intense. So those are the brows. So I zoomed you guys in a little bit, and now I'm gonna go in with two brow products. One is the NYX Control Freak, and then the Ardell Brow Sculpting Gel. And I'm just going to run these two through my brows. Okay, so there's that. Then I'm going to go in with the Ardell. So now that the brows are tamed down, or this brow is tamed down, I am going to go in with some lashes. So lash I'm gonna go in today is the Dodo lashes D0 or 0 105s. So that's what they look like. They come in this really nice case. I do have a coupon code with them, so I will have that link below if you guys do want to check them out. I really like the case on them. I like that you can see them. And these are so dramatic. These are crazy dramatic lashes, and I love them. I love these lashes so much, so I'm gonna go in with these lashes and I'll be right back. So lashes finally on. Now I'm gonna go on to contour and blush and highlight and all that stuff. So let's get into that. I'm gonna be using the E.L.F. This is St. Lucia blush and contour palette. So I actually really like this. So I think this is really, really good. I absolutely am obsessed with it. I'm gonna go in with a dual fiber brush. This is from Jessup. And I'm gonna go in with that contour shade and just contour my cheekbones. I know I've already contoured with the NYX highlighting contour palette, but I wanted to do a little bit more contouring. Cheeks are contoured. I'm gonna go in with a little bit more of the NYX highlighting contour palette. I went in with these two shades. Clearly you can see that Sculpt is my all-time favorite shade from the NYX Highlight and Contour palette. I do wish this had a mirror on it though. It would be great. That would be amazing. I'm actually kind of low-key loving this look. So if you guys do want to see this look, a full on face tutorial. Okay, so now I'm just going to go back in with that brush. And I'm going to use the blush side of this palette. So So then next I'm going to go in with highlight. And I think, do I have a highlight? Any new highlighters? I'm going to go in with a highlight shade that I don't necessarily use that often. This is an e.l.f. highlighter shade. I want to say this is in Sunkissed. And I'm going to take that on my Morphe 310 brush. I'm just going to get a little bit of that in there. It is very powdery, so beware. I'm also going to take a spray and just spritz my brush a little bit and then just highlight the cheekbone. I'm also going to go in a little bit on the Cupid's bow. I'm going to take a blending brush and dab a little bit in that. And on the Instagram side, just go over my lip a little bit. And by a little bit, I mean a lot. So, love that. Now on to the lips. What should I do for a lip? I'm just going to go in with Skinny Dip from Gerard Cosmetics. I'm going to go in with a little bit of Plum Crazy. So I went in with a little bit of Plum Crazy, or a lot of it, not a little bit. So here is the Instagram side, actually. Really like how this look came out. And then with the normal side. Normally, I do not wear any makeup at all. Sometimes I'll just take the Control Freak and just run that through my other brow. So that is it. This is the Instagram versus natural makeup look. Like I said, I don't wear makeup outside of like YouTube. On occasion, like literally occasion, if I'm actually doing something with work, then I'll have to wear like a teensy bit of makeup, but other than that, I wear nothing. So this is my natural look. I just throw on some brow product and that is it. And then this is the glam Instagram side. If you guys do want to see this look, let me know in the comments and I will definitely do that because I do love how this look came out. I think it's stunning and amazing. I absolutely love it. So, yeah. So, that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Be sure to click the thumbs up button and be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click that bell next to the subscribe button because YouTube has been like rolling around videos, so this video may not get to you if you don't have your little bell clicked so you guys will be notified when I upload. And follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat. All those are at TobinMUA. And that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys do want to see this look, let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.